Welcome back to Brian's Workshop.
Hi guys, welcome back to Brian's Workshop. Today I'm not doing what you would consider a conventional build video. In other words, I'm not going to be showing you how I built something. I'm going to be telling you about how I built something. I don't remember what video. It was about a month or two ago. I uploaded a project video and I showed a clip of my half-scale bowling lane. And ever since then, I've been getting messages through Facebook, my website, YouTube private messages, basically asking me how I build it, where I got the pins, where I got the balls, what kind of lane surface, what side, you know, just on and on and on and on and on. And, you know, I don't mind answering questions like that, but it's the same questions over and over and over again. So I just thought I would do a video that I could point people to that will answer those questions. So to start off with, the pins are, there's a company called Lens, and they make bowling shoes mainly. But on there, and they also do custom-made bowling pins for like birthday parties, specialty pins is what I would call them. Like a birth of a baby, they would make a pin that said, congratulations, it's a boy or it's a girl, whatever. But they also make these little half-scale pins. And these are real pins. They're made out of hard maple. They have the little hole in the bottom like a real pin does. They are coated with the same plastic and clear coat that a regular pin does. They bounce and roll like a real pin does. They are a real pin. They're just half the scale. So that's where I got those. There's going to be a link to that page where you can order them on their website. There'll be a link down in the description. I don't make any money off that, so if you want them, you can buy them. Great. If you don't, it doesn't matter to me. With a set of pins, you get one ball. Now, the pins, as I said, are true to scale. These balls are not. I did the math on them a little bit, and to scale these up, the diameter is not quite as wide as it should be, and this is more along the lines of, if it was a real size ball, it'd probably be like a 10 or 12 pound ball, which, you know, some people use the lighter equipment, but there's a lot of deflection as the ball enters the pins, and if you're a bowler at all, deflection is not a good thing for a bowler. You want a ball that's going to drive through the pocket. It's going to be grabbing the lane and heavy enough to actually resist that deflection. So, you know, starting out with, this is probably fine. My son and I, we decided that we would custom order some bowling balls, and there's a company called Epco that makes candlepin bowling balls. And they also do specialty orders. So we worked out the math, and we custom ordered, and I'll have to look up the exact size for this and post that in the description. But this is, the diameter is true to scale. If it was scaled up, it would be the right, correct size that a real bowling ball would be. And the weight of this equals probably about 15 pounds. If we ever got around to ordering a new set, we'd probably up that to 16 pounds because there's still just a little bit of deflection that probably wouldn't be there if it was a regular, 16 pound ball that we normally would use. The material of these is made out of just plastic. That does not grab a lane very well. This is a rubber, and according to American Bowling Congress rules, the softest that a bowling ball can be is 72D on the hardness scale. So that's what this is. And I drilled a couple little holes so we'd have something to actually, be able to roll up to put a hook on it. So with that being said, and remember, links will be in the description for all these. So let's move over to the lane and I'll show you a little bit about how we built it. Right here, what I'm showing you is the pin deck. And I have these old shop towels in the way here. In case we do happen to roll a gutter, it won't hit that sharp edge of that wood and damage the ball. I didn't make full gutters on this. A lot of people that do build these take like a PVC pipe and cut them in half and put them down there, but no longer than a lane is, we don't throw gutter balls that often. We just never got around to it, and honestly, I don't think we'll ever do it. The lane itself, when I first built this, we used laminate flooring, and you can do that. It's not a problem. The only issue I had with it was getting it flat and level and keeping it that way. Trying to figure out a way to attach it to the lane you know, if you try nails or whatever, eventually those nails might come loose, and laminate glue just didn't quite hold it. So I was having trouble keeping it attached to the plywood base. So what I did was, the bowling alley I used to bowl at a long time ago, I knew back in the early 90s they put in synthetic lanes, and I knew that the proprietor had some extra lane panels left over. So I checked to see if he had any, and he still did. And I made him an offer, and he sold me two pieces of it's the same surface that goes on a real bowling lane. And it's kind of like a compressed MDF, but it's a lot tougher than an MDF. You could hit this with a hammer as hard as you want, and you're not going to dent it. It's almost impossible to scratch. It's very durable. It's similar to what like you would put on a countertop, but it's a lot stronger than that, because this is meant for bowling balls that are actually dropping on it from, you know, you could drop a bowling ball from 20 feet or higher and it won't do anything to the lane. It's very stable. It's very hard to cut. Cutting these panels with my circular saw took quite a bit of doing, but I finally got it done. These panels have holes in it for you to attach it to the lane bed. It's, you know, if in the real bowling alley, and they make plugs for them to go in there. He didn't have any more of those, so I've just driven screws down through into the plywood base. Since nobody in our house is left-handed, the seams are on the left side of the lane. We play mainly in this area over here, so it's not an issue. If there was anybody, you know, left-handed that would be playing on this part of the lane, I would find something to cover that seam up and plug those holes. The lane area, or the pin deck area itself, in a real bowling lane, the lane would end right about here, and the back part would be a synthetic pin deck. I did not have access to that. He didn't have any, and I just didn't know what to do, so I just went ahead and continued the lane all the way back. Sideboards are made out of just regular hardboard, and I had a couple pieces of scrap laminate flooring left, which is very similar to a hardboard. So you get the kick of the pins, you know, it makes for realistic pin action. The gutters do slant back as in a real bowling lane. That also contributes to the pin action. Now, a regular bowling alley from the foul line to the center of the head pin is 60 feet long. So in order for this to be a true scale bowling lane, it would have to be 30 feet long, but my basement is not that long. So basically from my foul line here to the actual edge of the pit, of the pin deck, is about 14 and a half feet long. So, you know, it's just kind of a constraint. There's a doorway right here, so I had to stop the lane there. So 14 feet is what I've got to deal with, and that's, you know, I don't have any complaints about that too much. The only issue with it is a bowling ball has to have a certain amount of room for it to get into a roll and then react to the lane surface. So it's kind of a little short for that, but overall, if you keep the speed constant or consistent, you get a nice reaction at the back end. A bowling lane from one side to the other in real life is 42 inches, give or take a little bit. There is some leeway in that, but my lane is 21 inches from side to side, and the pit area is about 2 feet from the back of the pin deck and into the very back part of the pit. And that's enough room for the pins to go in and then go back underneath the ball kick, whatever that board's called, in back, so the pins are out of the way. We do have some extra balls. We tried experimenting with bocce balls and stuff like that, and we just couldn't find what we needed or what we wanted. So we went with the special order balls. Now, in real life, a bowling alley has oil from the foul line to, and it varies. Sometimes it goes just past the arrow, sometimes it'll go way up about 40 feet down the lane. And the reason for that it's kind of like, the best way I can describe it is like an airplane coming in for a landing. That wheel's gonna touch down, and you know that little puff of smoke and that screech of the tire, there's a lot of friction there, and it's damaging to the tire, and you will see skid marks on the runway. The same principle applies here on a lane. As somebody lets go of a ball, it's rotating in midair. And when it touches that lane, the friction, if there's nothing there to protect the lane, it will leave a burn mark or scorch on the lane itself. It damages the ball and it damages the lane. With the synthetic lane panels in real life, it's not as big an issue because it's very hard to damage these panels. But if it's real wood, they usually put a urethane coating over it to protect the lane. But that friction will eventually wear that urethane coating off, and you'll have scorch marks on the lane, and it will damage the wood and damage the bowling ball. So that it's just over time they've been putting the oil on the lanes. Now, coincidentally, that oil is what allows somebody to throw a hook ball. As the ball skids, makes contact with the lane, it won't get into a roll right away. It skids through that oil. Once it gets past that oil, then it starts to roll. And when somebody lets go of the ball for a hook ball, the ball is actually rotating in this direction rather than end over end. So as it gets past that oil, it grabs the lane and then it'll start rolling this way. So that's why you get a hook ball. So in order for us to actually have a realistic lane condition, you know, the hook and all that stuff, we tried furniture polish. We polished just about to the right, to about where I placed these arrows, probably about 2.5-3 feet. And that did okay, but that furniture polish kind of evaporates a little bit after a while. It's very hard to get a consistent lane surface. So what we've just been doing is putting a very, very thin coat of mineral oil on. And you get the nice skid through that, and then usually right about in this area here is when the ball will gain traction and start hooking other pins. And you get the nice angle and the realistic pin action. Okay, and the final questions that I get is, how much does something like this cost? Now, keep in mind, I did this about 6-7 years ago, so some of the prices I'm giving you may not be currently correct. For example, I don't know what the current prices on these pins and the balls are. But I seem to recall that a set of the pins and one ball was about $45-$50, and I could be off on that. And then the special order balls, if I remember right, we got two of them and they were just around $100. They may have changed their prices on that by now. Actual construction lumber, it's just 2x4s and a sheet of plywood and then a half sheet of MDF. And I think, let's see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, probably like 9 or 10 2x4s would do it, and then the sheet of plywood and a half sheet of MDF. And, you know, whatever that runs, you know, $75, $100 there. And then a box of laminate flooring, if that's the route you want to go. If you can buy them individually, great. But more likely, you'll have to buy an entire box. And those run anywhere from $30 up to $60, depending on what kind you get. If you try to go the synthetic lane panel direction, you probably will not be able to get these from a distributor. And even if you could, they are not cheap. Your best bet is to check around any bowling alleys that you have in the area that you know has synthetic lanes. Or even if a bowling alley has been torn down in your area recently, you may be able to get an entire section of lane, reclaimed bowling alley. That'd be a better way to go. But maybe, you know, you have a bowling alley in your area that got synthetic lanes recently and they have some extra panels that they'd like to get rid of. You know, maybe they'll make you an offer. So overall price, I would say on the low end of the scale, you're looking at $100-$150, but if, depending on, you know, how long you make it and how detailed you make it, you could get up to $300, $400, even $500 overall. That is just kind of depends on how much you're willing to put into it. So I hope that answers whatever questions anybody has. If there's a question you have that I have not answered, feel free to leave them down here in the comments, and I will try to answer it as soon as I can. I invite you to join me over on my Facebook page. The link will be in the description. Check out my website. There's a link for that too. And like I said, there'll be a link for the pins and the balls in the description. And there's a link to my PayPal account. I don't do this for a living. If you want to throw a dollar or two my way, that'd be great. And I will see you next time. Thank you very much.